G'day folks, welcome to Mt.Coramba Apiculture. It's Monday the 20th of January 2025. I'm just back up at Luena. It stopped raining, a stunning day up here. Just back at Luena, and I just had to put Bayvarol back into one of these hives that were badly infested with Varroa. I've just done that. What I thought I'd do is revisit this hive that had the high count, so 170 something, and it was the hive that was bearding which got my attention initially. So looking at the entrance to that hive there now, and there's no bearding at all, so it appears to be normal like the rest of the hives here. So what we might do is dig in and just see if we can find the queen and do an alcohol wash and just look at the comparison after having Bayvarol strips in for a couple of days. So let's dig in and get down the brood box of this hive. Alrighty, so we're down in this brood box. Get in here and find a queen and see if we can do an alcohol wash. So a bit of feedback from a friend of mine that after my last video, and there was concern that I was advocating the use of Bayvarol back to back. I'm actually not advocating the use of any chemicals. So much prefer not to do it, but you know, things have changed, and if you've got counts above the threshold, you need to intervene in some way. So the counts that I had, I'd really not, you know, 174 mites in a wash, it's not something you can just, you know, do a bit of positive thinking or wave some crystals over them, or even, you know, brood breaks and that sort of thing. It's just not going to cut it. So, you know, I looked through the table of treatment options I got, and the only option I got at the moment is Bayvarol, because I've got supers on all my hives, and the two organic methods that we've got available, it's too hot. So Bayvarol it is. Then, you know, there's plenty of summer here left up here. It's only the start of January. There's at least, you know, 2, 3, 4 months of summer left here. So, you know, I go through that process and ask myself the question, well, what if I pull the Bayvarol out and come back a month later and do another wash, and it's above the threshold again? So I'm still looking at Bayvarol as the treatment option, because I've still got honey supers on, and the organic methods, it's too hot to use them. So I'm not telling people that they have to use, that they should use Bayvarol twice, you know, in succession. Just saying at the moment, that's the only bloody option I've got. So what do, you know? I'm not prepared to lose hives to Varroa. It's still not an option for me. If you know my background, I'm not prepared to lose any hives. So the permit doesn't exclude using Bayvarol back to back. It says you shouldn't, but you know, you shouldn't use the same chemicals with the same mode of action back to back, and I get that. But when you have no option, you have no option. So that's where I'm at with it. Not advocating it, it's just the way it is. There are other options that are widespread in New South Wales, but I'm not going to bob up here on YouTube and advocate them either. So, you know, that's where I'm at. I'm easy to find. I'm easy to talk to. If you want to give me a call anytime to have a chat about what I'm doing, I love talking to people about bees, and if you feel I'm doing the wrong thing and you want to talk to me about it rationally, I'll talk to you. But, you know, as I keep saying with these videos, it's just a look over my shoulder, and it's just the thought processes that I'm going through, and I'm learning everything as well. So, yeah, that's where I'm at with it all. So, just trying to find this queen. So we can do a wash. Bees look great. They seem a lot more relaxed than they were the other day. Not that bees are relaxed or not relaxed, but yeah, they just seem calmer and a bit more content than they were. And as you saw in the opening shot, they're not bearding out the front, which is a big difference. No goose today. He's up at the front gate with his cattle, so that's a good thing. Had a lot of interest in the goose. I'm really not his friend, but I don't wish him any harm, but I'd rather he stayed away. And as usual, this queen's elusive. And we got it. Last bloody frame. Always the way. If I'd only started the other side, she'd have been on the first frame, but alright, we've got her safely in that queen cage, so let's do an alcohol wash, and yeah, just out of interest sake, see what sort of difference that Bayvarol made. Try and get shakes off a couple of frames to get a good sample. So that's a good solid. There's a good solid half a cup of bees in there. All right, let's get this hive back together and we'll go and do that wash. One thing I forgot to mention just when we were having that discussion about treatment with Bayvarol, I get the suggestion that, you know, when I was delivering the Varroa talks up here in New South Wales, you know, you're advising people when you're using the emmerdine-based mite treatments that, you know, all you got to do is take your honey seepers off and you can treat them, but then, you know, reality is that up here I never take my honey seepers off, and if you're down in the south of Australia, when you overwinter with singles, then there's a chance to do that, but it just never happens up here. So yeah, I get it that you can take your supers off, but in practical terms up here it's just not going to happen. Supers off a hive, unless you've got a large refrigerated shipping container, supers that aren't on a beehive are going to get slime with beetles in no time at all. So yeah, it's just not an option. Let's get this hive back together. So I just wanted to show you too my setup I've got for lifting supers off hives. So these are the sort of painting stands from Bunnings, and they're aluminium, they're easy to move around, the legs are, can go up and down, they just sit on the back of the ute. But most of my sites got a bit of slope on them, and they slip off these aluminium stands really easily. So I've had three full supers fall off these and smash all over the ground. It's a real mess. So went to Bunnings and got this stair, this rough stair stuff you put on the edge of stairs to stop people slipping. So I've now got a really nice non-slip surface, and with one person and 70 hives and no lifting equipment, I just find it much easier on the back to lift onto this level here rather than to put supers down on the ground on a lid and then have to lift them straight up, all the way up again. So plus my hives are on a bit of a stand too, about 10 centimetres off the ground, so it just adds a bit of extra height. So yeah, if you're a bit like me and a bit of a sore back and heavy supers, you might want to think about something like this just to save yourself a bit. Right, so we're back at the back of the ute and got our 300 bees in our wash bottle. Do a quick 30 second wash or a shake and see how the counts are going today. I think they've been in for 2 or 3 days. It's a noticeable difference. Just hold this up to look. One. So yeah, possibly about a 6 in there. So yeah, that's gone from 174 to 6 in a couple of days, and you know, they're probably just mites that have hatched and come out of the brood that have just hopped onto bees and haven't been affected by the Bayvarol yet. Here's this bloody goose coming. So with that extra shake, I reckon there's about 10. So yeah, once again, still a noticeable difference. So for everyone that asked me what difference does the Bayvarol make, there's your, the answer to your question. It's this bloody goose. It's just walked a kilometre to come down to yell at me. Go away, mate. So that's consistently staying about a 10. Yeah, so that's the end of the video with this damn thing here. How you going, mate? Yep, certainly, you know, it might still be just above, but just on or above threshold, but yeah, certainly that Bayvarol is going to have that effect for 6 to 8 weeks and keep those mite levels low, and then we can reconsider once that's done what we want to do. All right, that's it for here. Thanks for watching.